हाय गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द टॉपिक ट्रांसलेशन। सो व्हाट इज ट्रांसलेशन? बेसिकली वी विल स्टडी अबाउट दैट इन दिस वीडियो। सो बिफोर स्टडिंग द ट्रांसलेशन, वी शुड नो अबाउट वन थिंग, व्हिच इज द सेंट्रल डोगमा ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर बायोलॉजी। सेंट्रल डोगमा ऑफ बायोलॉजी इज बेसिकली अ काइंड ऑफ अ फ्लो चार्ट व्हिच शोज अस दैट डीएनए helps in making mRNA, which is messenger RNA, which we have studied earlier, and this process is known as transcription. And we have studied about this process in our previous videos. And mRNA is then converted into proteins. And every living organisms needs proteins, which because proteins are the building blocks of their body. So protein is needed by every living organism. So in this way proteins are made. So mRNA is converted to proteins, and this process is known as translation. So the process of making of proteins or polypeptide from mRNA is known as translation. So we will study about this process in detail, how this translation happens in organisms. Now the translation process happens in the ribosome, because the ribosomes produce the proteins. I think you know this thing, that ribosomes produce protein in the cell. So this process of translation happens in the ribosome. So this mRNA, which contains different base pairs, now these base pairs will be coded into amino acids. Now how this will be done is, the scientists have already discovered the genetic code. So now we know that the triplet or three codons like this, for example, if we take this, so GGG, now these triplet of base pairs will be known as codon. And these codons or the triplet of base pairs will code for a specific amino acid. Now, as we know, because the scientists have cracked the genetic code, so we now know that GGG codon will code for glycine amino acid. So this specific codon will code for glycine, which is an amino acid. This codon will be converted into an amino acid with the help of tRNA. As we have discussed earlier, that in the transcription process, tRNA is also formed with the help of RNA polymerase III. So this tRNA molecule will now help in the translation process by converting the different codons into amino acids. Now this tRNA molecule will come on this ribosome and will see this mRNA and will start to code the protein or amino acid from this mRNA. Now how the tRNA will do this? The tRNA will first come to this mRNA and will see this start codon. So a start codon is also present in the mRNA, which will initiate the translation process. So it will see the AUG, which is the start codon, and will initiate from any of the codon, will choose any of the codon, the tRNA will choose any of the codon and will start to make amino acid from it. So let's say this tRNA will come here and will choose this codon UCC. So this tRNA is basically a clove leaf like structure. So you can basically see this tRNA has a clove leaf like structure, and this codon binding end, which binds with the codon, contains an anticodon loop. This contains an anticodon loop. So this is known as an anticodon loop because anticodons are present here of the codon which the tRNA has to bind. So a tRNA is specific for a specific codon because it contains a specific anticodon loop as per the codon. So a specific tRNA will bind for to a specific codon and will translate or form a protein or amino acid. Now, this binding of the tRNA molecule with the specific codon is known as the charging of tRNA. This is known as the charging of tRNA or amino acylation of tRNA. So now UCC, as we know, codes for serine amino acid. So now this tRNA will code for a amino acid which is known as serine. So a serine amino acid will be produced here. So now not only one tRNA comes here in the ribosome, many tRNA comes in this ribosome. So one other tRNA will come here. Now I am representing this tRNA with a box because there is not enough space here. So this tRNA will contain an anticodon loop, obviously. And this tRNA will now form another amino acid. As we know, the GCA binds for an amino acid which is known as alanine. So another amino acid will be formed here. Now, like this, another tRNA will come here and will bind with this GUU. And here, another amino acid, which is known as valine, will be formed because we know that this codon, which is GUU, codes for an amino acid which is known as valine. Now, like this, another tRNA will come here and will bind with this codon, which is known as GGG. Now, this GGG will form another amino acid, which is known as glycine. As now here, all these tRNA are working in close association with each other and forming different amino acids. So now these different amino acids are formed, and these close working tRNA, because these are working closely with each other, now the amino acid formed will make peptide bond formation between each other. So now serine will make peptide bond formation with this alanine, and this alanine will form peptide bond with this valine, and it will get attached to the another amino acid which is formed glycine, and another amino acid if is formed will also get attached to this. So different amino acids will get bind to each other because of the close association of the tRNA that are working with each other. So these different amino acids, when bind together, will be making a polypeptide or protein molecule. And after different amino acids are formed, a stop codon will be present at the end. So UAG is a stop codon. So as the tRNA comes here, it will see the stop codon and will stop its function, which is translating. So after coming here, the tRNA will stop producing different amino acid or the protein molecule. So in this way, the translation process will be stopped, and we will get the polypeptide or protein molecule from this. After the formation of this polypeptide or protein, the polypeptide or protein will be released from this ribosome, and the translation process will be completed. So in this way, the translation process is done, and in this way, protein is formed in the ribosome. So I hope everything is clear. And if you have any doubts, you can ask them in the comment section.